Ja, jetzt zum Thema. Wir haben heute Morgen direkt einen großen Start mit einer Podiumsdiskussion zum Thema System Change mit Instagram, Social Media und die Zivilgesellschaft. Über die Abhängigkeit der Zivilgesellschaft von Social Media und was sich dagegen tun lässt. Und wir haben hier einige Organisationen und Personen mit dabei. Und genau, und wir fangen einfach mal an mit der Vorstellungsrunde der einzelnen Personen und Organisationen. Genau, damit gebe ich über erstmal zu Ende Gelände.
Anmerkung des Übersetzers, momentan ist noch nichts zu hören. Okay, remark by the translator, we can't hear anything at the moment. Okay, now we have a sound. We are Ende Gelände, we are an anti-capitalist organization and our origin is in the anti-nuclear movement and we have become a more general environmental organization now. We have realized that we have to take climate justice into our own hands.
Is Extinction Rebellion da?
Is Extinction Rebellion present?
No. Ja, Extinction Rebellion.
Hi. Extinction Rebellion is a movement in the area of climate justice. We are similar to. We're similar to Ende Gelände in that we tend to use massive civil disobedience, but with a focus in cities instead of outside of cities, and it started in England.
Ich glaube, ich bin dran.
I think it's my turn now. I'm from Fridays for Future, and we're active with school strikes and big climate strikes and some other things for 3 years now, active in Germany. It's probably nothing new for you, but I'm very glad to be here today, and I'm not sure who's after me, but I would hand over to Max from Concept. Something.
Ja, danke dir. Danke für die Einladung. Mein Name ist Max Brandenburg. Right.
Thanks a lot for the invitation. I'm Max Brandenburg. We're an association in the west of Leipzig for 10 years now, and we are mainly active with a social ecological transformation, so a fundamental change of society. We think that this is because of the climate crisis that was already named here and other issues that is very necessary, and I'm working there in the area of digitalization. We try to look at that in different areas. My area is digitalization, and that's why I'm here today and looking forward to the discussion. And I'm handing over to, I think we said now it would be the pirate party.
Stephanie Henkel, alias Ök. I am Stephanie Henkel from the Pirate Party, and one of our central topics is digitalization. And I'm here for the Pirate Party Saxony, because because I'm taking care of social media, and I'm doing posts for masks on social media to communicate our politics to the public.
All right, I'm Padeloon from Digital Courage, and we are working since incredibly decades on a digital world worth living in, and we recognized early how dangerous this digital connectivity can be if you just let it happen and let the powerful become more powerful and the powerless become more powerless. And so we are trying to find elements how you can do something about this injustice in the digital world and the world, how we can eliminate this injustice.
Okay, thank you. I'm Carsten. Und I'm part of the Bits and Bäume Movement.
Konferenz 2018 hervorgegangen,
and we were created out of a conference where several environmental organizations and organizations of the hacker scene talked to each other, and where we discussed digital rights, and it was a very interesting weekend at this conference, and then we created our movement. And the aim of this organization is to create a stronger connection between those two parts of society, so the ecological and the hacker cultures in Germany, because there's not that much happening in politics.
Und deswegen ist es wichtig, dass die Zivilgesellschaft weiterhin Druck macht.
And that's why it's important that the civil society is also becoming active. And I'm curious how this discussion today will fold out.
Aber auch von möglichen Verbesserungen genauer zu
analysieren. And I hope we can talk about potential misunderstandings, but also about ways to improve.
Zuspitzen möchte mit den sozialen Medien.
Because social media is a difficult topic. The whole discussion will be separated in three topics. The first is the current usage and significance of social media for our work. And we also want to talk about solutions to the different problems. And now I want to start with the current use of social media. And I would like to ask you, how do you currently use social media? And I would appreciate if you keep it short. And the more digital organizations here can also say something about this.
Ende Gelände, Struppi, du hast das Wort.
So, Ende Gelände, it's your turn. Yeah, thank you.
Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Telegram,
our YouTube primary platforms are Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Tinder. And we also use the Fediverse, so we use PeerTube. So, at Mastodon, we have 1,000 followers, at Facebook, more, at YouTube, 2,400, which is still a lot more than what we have on PeerTube. We use it, and we need it, because we need to have reach. Thomas, your turn.
Danke, ja, wir sind auch auf sämtlichen...
Thanks. We are also present on various social media platforms, but also in the Fediverse, we have 4,000 followers on Mastodon, but the numbers on Facebook are over 5,000, and on Twitter they are also significantly larger than in the Fediverse, so it's about factor 10.
Als die im Fediverse. Ja, und bei uns ist es auch so, also da
wir eine Bewegung sind, we are a movement
eine Massenbewegung,
that aims to be a mass movement.
Als Ziel hat, und dementsprechend auch möglichst breit
Schichten. And that's why we try to reach out as broadly as possible.
Deswegen sind eben
and die, that's why momentan the commercial social media platforms are also something that they are also very important, the commercial social media platforms for us, because we want to reach and mobilize people for actions.
YouTube und PeerTube für uns sehr wichtig, um da Aktionsvideos teilen zu können.
And we also use PeerTube to share action videos. But also we like to refer to other action videos from other organizations.
Eine riesige Rolle. Also wir haben auch sehr reichweitenstarke Accounts. Also
all right, we also have an account with a lot of reach, so over 500,000 followers. on Twitter over 200,000. We're on Facebook. We have a TikTok account as well. So I think it goes in all different directions. And most active is definitely Twitter. And the people who are active here from my generation, so those are the channels that are closest to us. We don't always know how to use Facebook. And I think you can say that it's very important. So we know how much people, young people, inform themselves about politics on social media. So we see it as our a big task to talk about the political events and concepts of climate justice and other things and distribute this information. But at the same time, social media is a great mobilization factor for us. So people need to find out that something is happening, that you might want to get active, that something is happening, and show different ways of action there. So it's not our only platform. We also have direct means of organizing directly in schools, for instance. Print materials, we have email newsletters, maybe like other organizations. We have a lot of partners that join our calls for action. So we're working with unions and parents' organizations, but social media has a very, very important role. And we're very dependent on it, of course. So if people are asking what happens with Fridays for Future, then they have to go to Instagram.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for these impressions. And how does it look from the conceptual side?
All right, of course, we don't have such a big reach as was named just now, but we also use classical social media. We have a Facebook account, a Twitter account, an Instagram account. That's the most recent one. And I think from what Paulina just said, we've learned that we would, if we didn't have Instagram, we would just age together with our Facebook target group, and many young people only perceive us if we're on platforms like Instagram. Yeah. But we also, and it's also important to us, we've always said that people who don't use social media should be able to find all our content and events. So that's why we have a website that we take care of where events are uploaded. We have a blog where we post blog posts, and we have project-specific things. I work in with Digital Movement, I think, and we have a blog there, and we have a website that's relatively important for us. That's endlichwachstum.de, so finally growth, where we make educational materials available for free. And we also have a classical email newsletter, which is a relatively important element of our publicity work. I think there are 6,000 people there or so. That much for now.
Super. Dann machen wir jetzt mit der
Datenreihenfolge weiter. Okay, now we continue in the original order.
Ja, ich freue mich erst.
All right, Digital Courage. I am very happy that without us having mentioned it, we were approached by Bits und Bäume to lead this discussion or have this discussion, because we know we're sometimes the people that say, hey, even if you have a lot of followers, that's completely irresponsible, because what you do is something nice for the industrial military complex. You are publishing your protest structures for the secret services, including who supports you, who is a member of you, and so on. And yes, you are rewarded for this in your limbic system through large follower numbers and likes, but you are delivering to the military-industrial complex this information and nothing else. And what I thought was very nice now, Max said just now, we maintain our own website, because the important thing is, if I'm having a deal with the devil, and Facebook is the devil, Instagram is the devil, and everything that comes from big corporations to market ourselves is the devil, and we have to take people away from there. Yes, it's important to protect the climate, but it is equally important to make people responsible for themselves. And when you say, okay, it's working on Instagram, we will only do our calls to action there and on Facebook and on Twitch, and look how many people there are. At that moment, you are ensuring that people remain not responsible for themselves, instead of being taking responsibility for your task and taking people there where they are responsible for themselves. With email, for instance, with chat, you have to be difficult or careful, because our possibility to influence legislation, for instance. So this is the responsibility we have with your 44 million people or whatever, to lead people to the right structures and to create this structure yourself, and not look where are there structures that you can trust. So you don't use an GMX or Google account. Of course, you don't work on Google Docs, which a lot of you probably do. You should use CryptPads and so on. And the responsibility for you is to use this reach you have, because your window of opportunity is currently open, to use this reach to move people towards paradise and not towards hell. So much from me for now.
Okay, we realize this is not going to be a boring discussion.
Ich würde trotzdem erstmal gerne noch die Eingangsstatement-Runde komplettieren.
I would still like to complete the initial statement round. So Stephanie, take it away.
Dann so.
Okay.
Ich würde mich gern komplett Padaloon anschließen, aber
I would like to fully agree with Padaloon men, but it's not the same. It's not so easy. There are three main platforms where there are Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We have our video channels, and our most important platform is our blog. And we always have our website. But the reason why this is not so easy, why we use social media at all, is visibility. If we only send information into our bubble, then it simply doesn't have the reach. It's only the people in our bubble that see what we do, what we want to tell them. And I'm doing a lot of advertisement on Twitter and also on the Fediverse. And if I don't speak to others, then they don't know who we are. And we also have so many explanation videos. And now we have it's really nice to have these environmental organizations. We're getting in touch with the environmental organizations that are also present here, and it's unfortunate that we can only reach out to them on these commercial platforms, which is really bad. And we want to be reachable through all channels. It's also a matter of being reachable. And this is something that we can only achieve if we are also present on these large commercial platforms. And now I'm very curious what your responses are.
Genau, Thomas, du warst der Erste.
Yeah.
Und dann
Max. Thomas, you're the first, and after that, Max.
Yeah,
I actually didn't want to get full into the discussion, so this is just like an appendum. Of course, we also have a website that is very well curated and maintained, and we show our upcoming events on the website. It's our aim that there is no information that is exclusively on one platform, because otherwise we would lose important target audiences.
Und natürlich einen sehr großen E-Mail-Newsletter haben wir auch.
And of course we have a large E-Mail-Newsletter. But that is more complementary.
Auch, in den Social Media.
Most people use several channels.
Ja, dann mache ich mal weiter. Also erstmal danke.
All right, then I'll continue. So first of all, thanks for bringing us to the point, Padelun. I thought it was interesting how we can quickly reach the important points of this debate. So I wanted to put a protective hand over the climate movement. I was active there long myself, and I have to say it is really great that people do this work, because without these people, these topics wouldn't be present on social media. And I would see these platforms as a kind of mutated public space. So it is a public space which is controlled by profit-oriented companies and which ought to be in the democratic public bodies, and there are projects like the Fediverse that try to build up alternatives, but I also think that I would address the digital civil rights movement like this. You have to demand digital regulation, you have to demand public interfaces, you have to demand public money, public code, so it's not all decided with just one tool, and I think that we have to say, we see what the different things are and look into the educational aspect, and we need more education to lead people towards alternatives which aren't already in this bubble. We've also tried to create educational materials there. There's this Chaos macht Schule, so chaos school there, and different approaches which I think are really cool. And I also think what Thomas also said, you use these devils, Facebook, Instagram, and so on, to lead attention to your own content and your own website and your own systems to lead people there. And I think that's an approach that makes some sense in our social media work, how we should do it, maybe.
Okay. Okay, sehr.
Wir sind jetzt laut Zeitplan schon
okay, sehr.
Ich glaube, wir können
okay, we are slightly beyond schedule.
Vielleicht müssen wir, weil wir nicht zu viel voraus.
Okay, we're slightly off schedule.
Noch mal klar machen, warum bezeichnen wir denn jetzt die großen Datenraffer, hieß es glaube ich gestern im Vortrag.
Okay, we also have to explain why we call those big data aggregators as devils. Does someone here want to explain what the problem is? What is the problem with these structures? Padelun, you have a point?
Yeah, I will first answer this question and then say what I wanted to say anyways. So why have I just called these as devils? The reason is it's a bit exaggerated, but we call these data krakens or octopuses. They are intelligent animals, well-meaning, but we don't assume that these people building these tools are through and through evil, especially in the area of Facebook. I would say there are some people who are really terrible, whereas I have some respect for Google, but I think I can say here 20 years Big Brother Awards, and you can read each speech that we had there, and you can see there why we have to move away from these structures and take people away from there, and that we cannot support this any further. Or 2012-13, Edward Snowden demonstrated a lot of these things that we knew before in the nerd circles, how much we are really used as cattle, as useful cattle, and it is difficult. I also have to understand this first. At the moment where we feed Facebook, Twitch, Instagram, and so on with our data, we make it more interesting, and what we have to do is get people out of there. And there's one additional difficulty. I'm not going to say everyone needs to be in the Fediverse tomorrow, because the Fediverse could not deal with that, because that's done created by nerds, and most instances would break down, including our own digital courage one. So in 30-40 years, we have to deal with 30, 40 years of nerd failure, where nerds have failed to follow up on these ideas of decentralizement and build up real communication models where we really have our own structures that are democratically managed and where we can make compromises and where we can deal with 500,000 or 44 million users distributed across very, very many instances. This is what we have to achieve. But please, not everyone join the Fediverse tomorrow, because then it would also perish.
Okay. Was that the reply, or was that your mom comment?
That was both.
Damit wir so ein bisschen die Redeanteile gleich verteilen. Ich habe
okay, to balance out the amount of speaking everyone gets. I think several people want to say something. Can you please wave into the camera if you want to say something? Because I lost the overview.
Vielleicht auch noch mal aus den Reihen.
Maybe.
Extinction Rebellion. Nee, hat man schon.
Maybe Extinction Rebellion, if you want to say something.
Der Vorwurf der Verantwortungslosigkeit könnte
so the claim of responsibilitylessness or lack of responsibility is something that we might want to discuss.
All right, I think this is somewhat justified, this accusation, and I would say that the climate movement is not on the same footing as the people who, I mean, you've done this for a majority of your life. Deal with this, and I think we can see this as a societal problem, that most people are not dealing with this, and most people are not dealing with these social media companies responsibly, such as Facebook. And I think there's a lot of different things here in an IT and digital area where we have this lack of responsibility. But in these large organizations, including Fridays for Future, we have a lot of responsibility, more than me as an individual, maybe. But I would say at this place that I don't think everything is going to change through this thing. So if we talk about the climate crisis, then my biggest nightmare is always this argument, which has been put forward for decades and which is always promoted heavily by the fossil industry, to say we will solve this if you individually stop eating meat, or if you now use green electricity instead of fossil fuels, and if you don't fly into vacation again. And so you take this huge systematic problem and put it on the individual to solve the responsibility. And then you say, if everyone individually does their part, then we can solve this. And with climate, it is very clear this is a lie. It cannot work like this. The problem is way too complex. And I would, with some naivete in the subject, I would put forward that it is similar in this problem. So we have these huge corporations that are very established, and we are not going to solve this just maybe exaggerated, but because some nerds and convinced people are going to switch to the other side. I believe that you have to get into the right habits with the climate as well, and you need these collaborative projects, and it's probably the same with digitalization. Pardon, you said this just now. There have to be people who join you. But I also think that at the end, the conclusion has to be that there has to be a strong movement for digital civil rights, for IT security, for data protection, for all these big subjects. There has to be this civil movement. And correct me if I'm wrong, maybe I'm saying things that aren't right at all, but we need regulation by the state there and systematic change there, which doesn't just start from us as individuals and not just us as large actors of the climate movement, of course, but in the end, we are still small fish in this really, really large system. And Palin says, okay, I was talking to you as association, not individually. Okay, but our 500,000 followers are, of course, a large amount, but if I look at what a huge corporation Facebook is globally, then we're still a very small part of it. And I don't want to completely abdicate responsibility, but there has to be a second layer, definitely. Doesn't mean that we're not responsible for anything, but it would also be wrong to have these accusations.
Okay. I would like to hear Struppi.
Okay, wunderbar. Ja, also klar, in gewisser Weise ist das ein Pakt mit dem Teufel, das sehen wir auch so.
Yeah, in some ways it's a pact with the devil. Menschen, die gerade bei Ende Gelände but einsteigen, we hope that people who join Ende Gelände, that they become politically and also digitally educated.
Leute ins Fediverse zu schicken. Also
and then we send people to the Fediverse, and on our website we also link to PeerTube to show to make it possible to have a transition to these free platforms. And we have the movement Activism International, which established an infrastructure that also has the task to educate users for them to better understand what the problem it is to give all this data to the big corporations. But to establish connections to outsiders is much easier on the big platforms. And every action is only so good as the media echo that the action gets. And if we just have a few thousand people in Mastodon, it just doesn't give any resounding effect because it's too few people.
Das ist mir tatsächlich auch nochmal wichtig zu betonen, das, was
and it's important for me to emphasize that that what the climate movements have done in the last couple of years, where they basically did the pact with the devil, they still managed to create a big discussion in the public about these platforms. And I have to shortly talk about the system. The system is just a system because we are part of it. And who should change it if it's not us? And as an individual, you can pull other people over.
In den Vorstellungsposts geschrieben and, haben, ja, ich bin hier, weil Ende Gelände hat Werbung gemacht. Das
and,
oder
yeah,
viele Leute, ich erst
when Ende Gelände started using Mastodon, we also saw people changing and we also saw people posting, yes, I'm here because Ende Gelände made these Mastodon posts. So it is, in fact, possible to use those free and privacy respecting platforms.
Das kam gestern schon in einem Talk.
And yeah.
Die Extremeren, die werden nicht so viel angezeigt, weil der
so
da ist und die Meinung bildet.
The problem is also that on the big platforms that the climate movements, especially the more radical ones, don't get many impressions on the big platforms because the algorithm classifies them as less interesting for the majority of people. And some of us have also experienced that accounts have been deleted on these big platforms, and then you lose your voice. And of course, I'm also just a small person, and I don't have that many people, so many followers on the Fediverse, and I had to reach out to do political campaigning on the big platforms.
Thomas, du hast,
Thomas, you had a point.
Ja, ich wollte auch nochmal eingehen auf dieses, ich sage nochmal, die Menschen dort abholen, wo sie sind und dort hinbringen, wo wir sie haben wollen.
I want to talk about getting the people from where they are at the moment and then taking them where we want them to be. And we can reach many people at the big
überlegt mal,
platforms. Wir
hier das System verändern, aber,
but then we also have to tell them, hey, you want to change the system and you can't do that within a controlled walled garden. There are alternatives, they are different and they break out of the system, but we consider them to be an effective way to use these alternative platforms. And it's also a difference for us when it comes to outward-facing communication and internal communication.
Weniger ausgeprägt, die
nutzen auch, in Germany, it's Docs für und weiß der Geier, wo so in Germany, we actually are much more aware of the problem, but in other countries, activists are using, for instance, Google Docs to plan their actions. And this is something where we think, oh no, this is a really bad idea. And therefore, it's important that we have better activism infrastructure across the world.
Okay, kurze organisatorische Ansage. Wir nähern uns der 45-Minuten-Marke.
Okay, we're getting close to the 45-Minutes mark, where we want to open the discussion.
Und dann würde ich gerne noch irgendwie
so Max, it's your turn. And then I would like to come to concluding remarks. What we want to do, once we have determined, made it clear that we actually have a pact with the devil and how we deal with that.
All right, I think one interesting aspect from this aspect is what is coming for us. So one aspect of the digital lifestyle, which wasn't named now, is that we contribute to the climate crisis ourselves as well, and this is only growing in influence. There is something from the Climate Institute, I can link it later, which says that in Germany, the carbon footprint of the digital lifestyle, including social media, is 5.8 tons, which is not that much for a German on a German scale. But we have to get this down to 2 tons in total. And if we consider that the digital market is growing faster than anything else, we have to have this debate, and we will see each other again in this circle maybe. And there we have this opportunity to learn from each other as a climate movement and digital rights movement, because it's important that the climate movement can be the multiplicators for the messages of the digital movement and vice versa as well. And for this reason, here's a short ad slot for the Bits and Bäume collective, where I think it's important to discuss these questions.
Okay, very good. And I would like to make a quotation.
Den Satz gesagt, wir müssen das Klima retten, aber wir müssen auch das retten, was wir brauchen, um das Klima zu retten, nämlich
die We have to save the climate, but we also have to save those things that we need to save the climate, which includes the freedom, the rights for freedom.
Auch im Interesse der
Klimabewegung. And that is also of interest to the climate movement. And just occupying vehicles is of course also important, but we also need to it's important to focus on stuff like outphasing coal, but there are also digital rights that we have to fight for. And we have to continue networking between both sides, between both topics, so that we can increase our own reach and use our own reach to create a future that is worth living in. And therefore, the question, how can we overcome this problem.
Ja, ich kann ja direkt mal anschließen zu dem, was du gesagt hast.
All right, and I can just join what you said just now. I also had to understand at some point as when an activist artist who thought it was great to work with technology and who then had to recognize what kind of an existing knowledge I had and to build an organization. And when you make a start and then you build up a movement, then you take everything that's there, but then you have to learn and understand what it means to create a job position and to pay taxes and everything, just like you have to build up your IT, where most companies aren't very interested because it's not their core business. But as organizations, with our IT and our legal business, we have to operate sovereign in a sovereign way. And this is the responsibility that we get through due to trying to make something good. And we don't have to be sad about this. And this is how the world keeps developing in a good direction, by doing everything that's necessary and not just the one thing. Because as Eric Satie said, so that's a misattributed quote, if you only understand something about music, you don't understand anything about music either. And you don't have to be silent very loudly.
Okay, to keep up with what you just said in terms of artistic performance, that's difficult, but it's a nice quote.
And Instagram Accounts, spitze es mal zu, sich vorstellen, irgendwie einmal im Monat oder einmal im halben Jahr oder so Posts abzusetzen, wie
can you imagine
ist totaler Mist
that, und that if you have an Instagram account with high reach, would you consider it possible to send a message once a month, hey, Instagram is shit, let's move somewhere else? Do you think this is something that's possible?
I would say, in general, I think that's an option, and I don't think that's something that people in the climate movement would disagree with, but I just have this one thing that I experience often. I do the publicity work for Fridays for Future, and what happens every day is that we have 200 people saying, hey, we also have this problem and it would be great if you could look into this as well. And a lot of people in this round will probably know this as well. And it is difficult to focus there. And I noticed even in the climate team where I was thinking, oh, there are so many things we could talk about, this policy here in traffic and here in renewable energy. And we also want to talk about justice questions. We don't want to be focused on Germany. We want to talk about international subjects and colonial causes for the climate crisis, for instance. Where are there people who are more endangered than others, and who is causing all of this? And at some point, I talked with school friends, and they were asking, so Pauline, what are you doing there? Are you now a movement for everything? And they didn't even understand. And so I was realized, okay, we're talking about important things, but it seems that we're doing something wrong in our communication if it's only targeting a small bubble. And so I don't see ourselves as doing this because there's too much going on in this channel. But I think it's very important to have something like Bits and Bäume, a separate communication channel, a separate organization, which combines this. Which is for people who are interested in climate issues and also digitalization and data protection and putting this together. And I think we need a lot more projects combining this. But I think this approach of everyone has to do everything, we are not going to get far with this. Not everyone can do everything. If I'm just thinking of myself, I don't have the time to do everything that would be necessary. And in the same way, a great organization like Fridays for Future doesn't have the capacity to do everything that would be necessary. But that's why I think it's very good that we're talking together and can discuss how synergies happen and maybe start projects together to ensure that individual projects aren't just diluted, okay. But still furthering something.
Das hatte jetzt schon den Charakter eines Schlussworts. Ich habe noch drei.
Okay, that was almost like a conclusion.
Bei 12:15, das heißt, eigentlich müssten
wir jetzt 12:15 and now we need to take up some questions.
Okay. Also Struppi und Thomas jeweils ganz kurz und dann gehen wir in die Fragerunde.
Okay, Struppi und Thomas, you say one more thing and then we start with the questions.
Ja, genau. Also ich sehe auch, dass das Klimathema sehr intersektional ist.
The climate topic is very intersectional. And we use our reach to send our message and also to give this to people who actually know something about this. And it's impossible to take care of all topics that can only go wrong. And that's why we give the word to people who actually understand what they are saying. And we use that reach. And we also delegate that reach to people who should be heard. And it happens often that we have small things and it's very dangerous because you can lose yourself in a small topic. And digital and digitalization are important topics to us. And we also delegate our reach if it makes sense or
ja. Ja, und dann Thomas, du wolltest noch was sagen?
Thomas?
Genau, ja, ich wollte auch mal konkret zu deiner Aufforderung, von wegen könntet ihr euch vorstellen, da
regelmäßig solche Posts raus. I wanted to specifically comment on your question on, okay, do we want to send a message every month? Okay, hey, this platform is shit, move somewhere else.
Da fehlt auch noch ganz viel Aufklärungsarbeit.
Also, I think there's a lot of explanations and education missing for people. So we have some people who know a lot about technology and the problems with it. And I think those people also need to talk to the people who actually manage the social media channels. And then we can, because I realize that there is some understanding of the problem, but it's not that deep. So there is some knowledge sharing required still.
If I can just say one more thing regarding Pauline, it is very important to stay focused on your main subject, to not hear, listen to everything that's being carried towards you, but to include it in your work. So we're not doing extra work on the subject of anti-fascism, for instance, but it is, of course, internally important to us. So stay focused on your subject. That is important. And I noticed this in the working group against preventive data storage. It's important to include this.
Dann würde ich jetzt einmal sagen, wir versuchen, es ist ja
okay, I think we now try to
zum Beispiel, dass er noch Links bereitstellen will, die landen dann alle auf
okay, okay, so there will be links.
Dazu halte ich jetzt einmal die URL in die Kamera, das müsst ihr euch
so this is the URL.
Wenn man dann später mal die Aufzeichnung anguckt, dann ist das wahrscheinlich der einfachste Weg, um
okay.
Um das
one,
zu,
if you're watching this video at a later time, then this is the best link that you can use to contact us.
Ob man das lesen kann? Wahrscheinlich,
wenn so, is this readable? If you make it large enough, then it should be readable.
Schreibe ich das in den Chat und jetzt gehen wir,
and I'm writing this into the chat. And we're proceeding to Q&A.
All right. So I can say thank you already to everyone. It was very interesting. And as you can see, it's definitely a subject worth talking about. And this is already reflected in the questions we have. So we have a lot of questions collected already. And Yeah, I would start with this one. What I think is very interesting, when you're on Facebook or Instagram and looking at the comments and posts you have, do you really only look at the number of followers, or is there some kind of rating for the interactions or other statistics that you look at? Because we've learned already that the algorithms are very selective there and not necessarily send these posts to the people, that the posts don't arrive at the followers. Do you have other statistics or metrics there that you look at, or is it mainly we have that so and so many followers and so many likes?
I don't think we can hear from every organization because we don't have the time. So please raise your hand if you want to say something.
Ja, dann Stefanie.
Ich möchte Stephanie? Würde aber gerne eine Umweltorga Vortritt lassen, falls
I would like to answer, but yeah, okay, so I will answer. It very much depends on the platform.
Gucken die, die das hauptsächlich betreuen, sehr viel auf die Zahlen, aber
Twitter and YouTube, the people who manage this are shown very much on the numbers. But on Twitter, there are almost only trolls. On Facebook, there are a lot of insults. And on Mastodon, we actually have good content, good comments. And when I want to ask something and want to get a good answer, then I post it on Mastodon. So, but you don't get, or you very rarely get constructive feedback on Twitter or on Facebook if you post your questions there. Yeah, but it's very platform dependent if we look at the numbers. We can't hear Struppi right now.
Wir sehen das eigentlich genauso wie Ök-Ök. Also bei uns ist
es auch so, dass it's similar im Fediverse in our case.
Sind. Die Kritik ist solidarisch, aber konstruktiv.
So, it's more constructive in the Fediverse.
Hate, einfach nur Hate. Und
on Facebook, there's so much hate.
Reichweite, also
so you get a lot of reach, and Facebook loves reach. But it's also very focus on hate. And on Twitter, it changes from time to time. So the useful exchange of ideas is in the Fediverse is much better in the Fediverse.
Alle weiteren Wortmeldungen jetzt zu der Frage vielleicht auf die
Q&A verschieben. I would like to move all further answers to that question to the extended Q&A.
All right, yes, we have more questions. Generally, wouldn't it be possible to have a corporation or a collective out of this group, maybe? We have now digital experts and also climate experts in this group. Wouldn't it be possible to create a group here so that each individual can stay in their area of expertise, but then a certain educational effect happens, and then we can work together in a targeted way and maybe create a new association out of these synergy topics.
Max, du möchtest was sagen.
Max, you want to say something?
Klingt total geil.
That sounds good, but I don't have time. I don't know if the others feel the same. And to some degree, this already happened with Bits and Bäume, because we are a network that tries to connect those organizations. But of course, you can start your own initiative. I think it's interesting that we think of the Instagram Destroy Instagram campaign only as a destroy Instagram and not more, because this also tells us something about the state of the debate. Ja.
Da springe ich jetzt mal aus der Rolle des Moderators in die Rolle des
Vertreters. From moderator to member of Bits and Bäume. I think this is a topic that is worth keeping working on. And I think it would be good if we have something that we can give to people so that they know how to reach out to Bits and Bäume and how to get better connections between environmental and digital organizations. And I think in Nordrhein-Westfalia there will be a Bits and Bäume conference soon. And I would be very surprised if that topic is not going to be at that conference. On our website, Digital Courage, there are tips and tricks for self-defense, digital self-defense. We try to educate people. We also have little brochures with safety advice. So our daily work is also about educating people, providing information material. And yeah, our fire is actually so cheap that they cause us financial distress. Please spread the word, spread our materials. And I think it's important to advertise the knowledge that we spread. And it's not, you don't need to necessarily create a new movement or a new group. You can also create new companies that offer services that are more privacy friendly, that are more eco-friendly, that are potentially both. And And I think it's important that people consider actually taking money for the things that they do. And sometimes it makes sense to use your reach to ask people to ask people for money for the value that your organization produces. Next question.
Yeah, okay, this has to be a very short question, I'm afraid. But would it, so why don't you just try to say, all right, we're putting up a poster on Instagram, okay, we're not here, we are now somewhere else. Would somebody be ready to try this out?
I like to answer, even though I talked so much already. You will lose your followers. Don't do this. We actually migrated our mailing list at the AK Forward, and we actually lost a lot of subscribers that way.
Thomas,
you have a point?
Ja, ich wollte eigentlich auch nur sagen, dass es, also da ist dann doch die Hürde zu groß.
I think also da muss it's too much of a hurdle for the for all followers to migrate to a new platform. Ja. So you really need to make the transition very, very smooth.
Du stößt den Leuten nur vor den Kopf. Und wer sich so bleibt bevormundet fühlt, der lernt nicht dazu und kommt auch nicht.
The problem is you're insulting people, even though that's not your intention, if you just leave them. I think it's, that's also my impression. We don't want to tell people what to do. We want to take them with us. We have to prepare the way that they can take. And that's why I don't think we will put up a sign and say, we're no longer here. Okay, it's 12:30. And I think this is the end.
Die URL ansagen, wo man,
wenn man
dieses Video sieht, vielleicht noch mehr Informationen
So I just want to show the URL again. So if you want to see, if you want to get more information, for example, in one year, and this is where the material that we will work out in the next year. If the URL shortener service still exists in the future. Bits und Bäume Dresden Seite, also Dresden, and it will also be on the Bits und Bäume Dresden website if you don't want to rely on the short URL.
Habe ich mich hier für einen Kurzdienst entschieden. Anderes Problem. Ich gebe das Mic zurück an die Herald.
And I hand over the mic to the Herald, and I'd like to thank everyone who participated.